button and then select star UML. If you have not installed star UML, better install your star UML. You can Google it. Star UML screen is like this. Star UML is an open source software. It's free of cost. Actually, as per syllabus, we need to perform it in a rational rows, but the rational rows is a proprietary software by IBM company. Its cost is high, so we are using open source software. In the star UML, click on file, click on new. Okay, you will get new file. Okay, you see evaluation model. Okay, so we have menu, file menu, edit menu, format menu. Format menu little bit different from other menus. Here what is the line color, line style, line shadows, just formatting approaches. Model, this menu option is very important. Model, you click on the model, click on add diagram, you see all the possible diagrams, class diagrams, package diagrams, object diagrams, composite structure diagrams, component diagrams, deployment diagrams, use case diagrams, sequence diagrams, communication diagrams, state chart diagrams, activity diagrams, profile diagrams, ER diagrams, flowchart diagrams, and data flow diagrams. In this case, we are going to discuss about use case diagrams. So I choose the option use case diagram. Go to model option, and that model, click on add diagram. In that, click on add diagram submenu, you choose use case diagram. Clear? Clicking on it. So you see left half, you can see the toolbox. Okay, the toolbox consists of package, use case subject, use case actors, frames, association, direct association, general association, and dependency, and the required other required tools. Okay, in the right half you can see the model explorer. Actually, I have selected two models, that's why it is giving like this. Previous model one model, this one is model one. Okay, this is my use case diagram. What is the purpose of use case diagram? Use case diagram represents the relationship between the actors and their use cases. So to draw the use case diagram, first you need to identify what are the actors involved in this. So in this library management system, we found four actors: master librarian and librarians, registered users, and borrowers. These four are the actors. Okay, the number of actors is not permanent. The number of actors depends upon the context, that means depends upon the situation. Okay, now I want to select the actor. Just left side menu, click the actor, just single click, and move your mouse to the canvas. You call it as canvas. Okay, here just hold the left button, press the left button, mouse left button, and drag your mouse. So the box is extending, that means your actor size is within that box. Just leave, once you fix the size, okay, if you feel the size is okay, then release the left button. Automatically it will give the attributes. So what is the actor and what are their attributes? So you see my actor is here. I want to give registered users, registered, registered user. Okay, you see the attributes also. So what are my attributes? You see visibility of this user, add note, comment, add attributes. You can add your own attributes. Next, add operations, what type of operations you want to perform. Add super actor, add sub actor. If you want to add one more actor associated with this actor, super actor and sub actor, and this is add associated use case. First you see, for example, what is super actor and what is a sub actor. What is super actor and what is sub actor? Just you see here, for example, Here I click. You see, add sub actor I have chosen. What is there? Just you see. Okay, like this. If you want to make it as a sub actor, just use delete. Click on that button. Click on that button. Sorry, make a double click. Make a double click. You will get the options. This is add super actor. This is add sub actor. Now I am clicking add super actor. You see. Are you getting? Just I am dragging the box. Actor, I have not added actor in the previous procedure. Just I have selected the option. So this is super actor, means this is the super actor. Okay. Now, if you want to get sub actor, just make a double click. This is the option. Add a sub actor. Okay. Like that, you can add the sub actor or you can add the super actor. Here I want to have sub actor, but I have showed both the options, super actor and sub actor. These lines also you can adjust as per your wish. The backside one is, you call it as canvas. You call it as canvas. It is like your normal drawing paper, but being an engineering student, all you are well aware about drawing. So here I want to give the actor name. See, make a double click. Make a double click. My next actor name is borrower. Okay, just double click. Next, I want to add one more actor. Click here. Click here and then come here, hold the left button, press and don't release, drag the mouse. Once you feel it is okay, just release the mouse. Now you give the actor name. For example, my actor name is Master Librarian. Okay, now I want to add one actor to this. You see, I want to add a sub actor. Just you see. If you don't want this, click on it and delete it. Okay. Don't leave the symbols unnecessarily. So here I have added four actors. I can adjust their places. Don't think that you need to drop there itself. Wherever you want, you can move like this. Okay. But better make it in the right position. Okay. Like this, we can adjust. Next, I want to give the name. Click outside and double point your mouse pointer to that name. Make a double click. So it will be selected and the name will be highlighted. So my sub actor name is Librarian. Okay. Now I want to give their use cases. Okay. Starting from registered user, I want to give use cases. I want to give it one by one. Okay, registered users. So at the time of registering, what you are doing, simply you call it as login. Okay, I want to give that use case. Click on it, make a double click, and you call it as use case. Add associated use case. Make a click. Just a single click. Automatically it will give. You can adjust as per your requirement. Position can be adjusted. Make a double click and give the name. So what do you want to do? Login. Okay, over. Another associated use case. What you want to do? Next one is after login, what you will do in the library system, you search the books. Next one, after search, what you will do, you browse. So browse for the given specific information. Okay, these are the use cases associated with the registered user. Next, come to the borrower. Borrower means the person who is taking the books. You call them as borrower. So first, what he will do, he will check out of items. He will check what are the books available, which books are ever useful for me. So first use case is check out items. So if you want, you can place it like this, or else you can change the direction also like this. Don't think that you need to leave it as it is. Make a double click. Check out of items. So you need to verify what are the books available for you, which books are suitable. So if and next, so whatever the books they have already selected or already bought, they can return their books. They can return their books and they can book the slots. Just wait, I want to adjust the place, or else we can adjust the physical size also. Okay, make a double click, click on the add associated use case, make a double click on the in the ellipse box. Ellipse box represents use case. Okay, next, make a reservation. Sometimes if you don't want to make a cancellation. These are the use cases that can be performed by a borrower. Sorry, I think I have given spelling mistake. Borrow, R was not printed. You can edit. I am adding R. Okay, now if I want to increase little bit size, I can move like this. So what you can play it like game. Don't think that it is a very difficult task. Okay, next one, master librarian. Come to master librarian. What will be the job of master librarian? So he manage the librarians. Manage the librarians. Don't think that only one librarian. There may be number of librarians. He can manage the librarian. The main job of master librarian is to manage the librarians. What these librarians are doing. So you give their attributes. Manage the titles. What book titles are there? Like that they manage the titles. That means what are the books with what titles, volumes, all those things they maintain. Manage the items. Again, click outside. If you want to add one more, make a double click and choose add associated use case. Then make a single click. It will give. Manage borrowers. Who are the users? Whether they are the genuine users or not, like that. Okay, that's all about use case diagram. Use case diagram for library management system. And last, is you see, once again, you have a look at the screen. Menu options, okay. Toolbox, and the right here, right side, you can see the Explorer. And then go to the file menu and click on save option. It will be saving. It will be asking some name. You give some name. For example, use case underscore LMS, Library Management System. Okay, now wherever you want, you can save. Just click on the save button. For example, if I want to save it in some more area, for example, if I want to save it in D drive, okay, I will save.